Sprite. Let's go. It's the third.
Want a Sprite, cranberry?
It's the thirstiest time of the year.
Hey.
It's the third.
Want a Sprite, cranberry? Want a Sprite, cranberry?
It's the thirstiest time of the year.
Hey. 'Twas the night before Christmas and Santa's a wreck. How to live in a world so politically correct?
His workers no longer would answer to elves. Vertically challenged, they were calling themselves.
Nothing that clamored or made lots of noise. Nothing for girls or just for the boys.
Nothing that claimed to be gender specific. Nothing that's warlike or non-pacific.
Santa grew weary of these tiresome moans and made him quite angry, I'll have you know.
He tried to be merry, tried to be gay, but you've got to be careful with that word today.
His sack was quite empty, limp to the ground. Nothing fully acceptable was to be found.
So two friends from across the seas, who met on the internet, wanted to see
if they could catch Santa and fill him with glee, but little did they know they'd need more than a tree.
For Santa was pissed, hardening his heart entirely. Hey Aaron, do you think that we will, like, actually see him?
No one's ever seen him before, but tonight is the night.
Okay, all my equipment is up. How's it going up there?
Yeah, all good up here. Oh, my God, your roof is atrocious. Christ, is that a dead bird?
I'm gonna go make the cookies now. How was that?
Oh, bollocks! My damn shoe fell off!
Okay, Aaron. We are 5,000 miles from landing. But there is this weird interference. Strange.
Oh, wow! A shooting star! Oh, wait. No, never mind. It's just a plane.
1500. But that sound is still there. It almost sounds like clapping.
Hey, Scruncho.
Hey, Aaron.
I would tell you a riff joke, but it might go over your head.
Don't you have something to be doing on that roof?
Oh, yeah, right, right.
50! You see anything?
No. But you've got some interesting neighbors.
Santa?
He's here! Oh my god! Scruncho! Oh! My shoe!
Is that a cat? Oh god! No! It's Santa!
Someone's been naughty and not sleeping. What is this? Ugly cookie.
Aaron, where are you? That clapping. It's in the house now.
Scruncho. I don't know what the hell this thing is.
Is getting louder. Oh god. It all makes sense. It's the clap of Santa's ass cheeks. Thank you. God! Aaron!
Please don't hurt my children. Leave us alone. I'll do anything.
Me and my family bought the house 2 months ago before it happened. We assumed someone was messing with us, or even that it was haunted by spirits. Last thing I remember seeing was a headless man standing in the doorway. And look at me now! Can't move. I can only talk to someone I can't even see. A head in a bag.
Hello. I hear you nearby. Listen, the house is not haunted. It's not. The house is just waiting for a special treat. Thank you.
That man appeared out of nowhere, just when I was about to leave for work. His head was gone, but he was still somehow able to walk towards me. And that's where it ended. It's waiting for a special one. I saw it, and I can still hear it. The house itself is crying, waiting. I can feel its hunger, even after all these years.
A man with special abilities. That's a feast worth waiting for. You are finally here. What a joy.
It used us to lure you in. I know you couldn't save my family, but I hope you can still save yourself. It's the house. It's not a building. It's a plant. A virus rooted on the surface of the earth. A being from centuries ago. Get out while you still can. The door is closing. Ahead of you. You did your best. Presents for the children. Years of joy. You will be remembered.
You will be remembered.
Found you.